the ditch brush of 16. Now heading towards that combination of the wagon and brush fence. Four strides in there. She gets them. So 95's away. This is Hazel Burgess. So if I get it wrong, maybe a combination would like to, one of the connections would like to come and tell me that it isn't. Landerwin Tomos, but we'll call it Tomos because it'll be easier. I'm taking the easy option. Clear over two, heading downhill towards three. This is first little question, it's a team house with a view, but it's a downhill takeoff, downhill landing, and then they sweep further down into the valley on a left rein. First combination, 4 and 5, which is the two walls. Okay, so it indicates that it was about a 4-stride distance in there. She's now climbing back uphill. Sets a pony up for this first combination. Only one currently on track. Flying over 4 and 5, so we're now heading towards the hedge of 6. Again, slight uphill. It's a fairly easy fence to jump on the uphill. Blue colours of Hazel and his 14-year-old Bay Geldim. Heading towards the ditch brush. 7. Clear of that. So, second main test. Question on this track. 25-metre track is the water complex. That's a step down into water. There's an alternative to that step into water. We call it length 41. It does take quite a bit of time wasted to get to that alternative. Certainly I didn't see any juniors attempt that. Sam, please take that opportunity to go and have a chat with them, see what products that they're doing. Tomos and Nigel Burgess, just a couple of fences left to go, the skinny and then the last. Mr. Frosty is ridden by Mel Howard. Clear over the first couple of fences, number 97. Just a score of 34.5. 9-year-old Grey Galdin representing the High Fen Riding Club out in East Anglia. Sticky over 5, but now approaching the hedge behind us. Just a minor adjustment with a knitting.
Final page. Appearing her a provisional final score of 113.3. Now the first of the riders from Scarborough. This is Hazel Burgess and Grand Reverie Tomas.
You put studs then?
Yeah. Woo-hoo!